Hey YouTube, Chris here today, just showing you the cold start on my Massey Ferguson 50E Power Shuttle backhoe. It has about 4,400 hours on it or so, and it has the Perkins diesel. I'm gonna get this thing cold started. It's about 26 degrees right now, and I'm gonna blade this road off a little bit because we're supposed to get a bunch more snow, and I don't wanna get too deep into it. And also, this machine's only two-wheel drive, so I might just get stuck today. Let's see what happens.
That's all, folks.
A few moments later.
Hey, we got it started, YouTube. I bought some brand new batteries for this thing a couple weeks ago, and it had 550 cold cranking amp batteries in it, two of them, and I replaced it with the same batteries, so I wasn't sure what this machine would need. I figured the old ones were, that one of them was no good, the other one was kind of okay, and it would hardly start, and that was wrong. So I figured with the two brand new batteries in there, it fire right up. But you spend a little more money, you can get the next grade of batteries from Napa, and they're 600 cranking amp, cold crank amps each, so that would be 1200 cranking amps. I have a feeling if I did that, it would have fired right up. And also a little bit of water on the battery because it doesn't have a grill on the front. I gotta get that made up or find one or make one. So it may have drawn some juice out of the battery from the moisture. Alrighty, we got it started, YouTube. I learned this trick with a torch from old school loggers up in Alaska and those gold mining shows where they throw a tarp over the tractor and put a torch under there to kind of heat her and put them up the machine. This way for me is a lot more easier than jumping it because I don't have a jump pack. So it almost fired up, but I heated the bottom of the oil pan up just for a couple minutes, and that made a huge difference. Almost fired. The batteries are pretty drained out, obviously, when you crank it on them. I don't want to get this thing ether drained. It seems to fire pretty good. It just needs a little better batteries. And it was pretty much done. I was like, dang. So I went ahead and warmed up the batteries just to get a couple more amps out of them before they completely end and fired right up. Alrighty, thanks for tuning in. Let's get to it. Alrighty, YouTube, we are all done. We got that thing started. It was really close to not starting, but we got it started. A couple tricks. We got the road bladed. There is rock underneath this, so there is some mud in some spots, but at least I got that scraped off. I want to get some more wood cut during the week, and we're supposed to get a bunch of snow, so if I can keep the snow down, at least on this little trail right here, that sure would be huge. Like I said, the machine's two-wheel drive, so it doesn't take much, and that thing starts sliding or gets stuck. As you saw, I was back dragging down this little hill right here, this little slope, and she was wanting to take off on me. So I would not recommend operating a two-wheel drive backhoe in the snow. I do have quite a bit of experience doing sketchy stuff like this, so it's not my first rodeo, but I would not try it. You should have a four-wheel drive machine for sure, full canopy, or tracks are huge also. I have a little track skid steer, but it's a little too small for this job I'm doing, and that machine, the parts cost a lot for it, so I try not to do too much with it unless it's a paid job. That, you know, this is just some firewood stuff I'm tinkering around on, getting my wood in. So thanks for tuning in, really appreciate it. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe button, and we'll see you on the next one.